It is a political witch hunt, and everyone knows it. By participating in this lawsuit, it would only serve to legitimize this perversion of our legal system and allow bad actors to interfere in our upcoming election. So I won't be taking part.
So that raw, unadulterated video of Kari Lake is her admitting that she is not going to participate in the defamation lawsuit that was lodged against her over her claims that she made in the wake of the 2022 election against Maricopa County Recorder Stephen Richer. So Stephen Richer, obviously, election official, she lost the election. And because she comes from the Trump wing of the party, that's not acceptable to just admit that you lost. So instead, you lash out at people. In this case, Stephen Richer, and you lie about him stealing the election from you. The thing is, that's defamation. And so she's not participating. But that's not really how lawsuits work. So it's still going to go forward. It just might be a bit quicker, and she's not really going to challenge it, but she still could suffer consequences, including monetary consequences.
Before we continue with the story, we depend on members to keep on going. Don't wait, click join now on YouTube.
I want to give you a little bit more from her before we discuss. She tweeted, "The political elite will do anything to hold on to power and stop outsiders like me. They've resorted to filing a ludicrous defamation lawsuit to try to stop me and bleed me dry." So not ludicrous, you lied about the guy. You knew when you said the things, they were lies. He just sued you over it. That's what defamation lawsuits are about. But taking part in this lawfare just legitimizes it. Again, everything that challenges them is lawfare. They sue people left and right. That's not lawfare, okay? All the lawsuits against the Biden family and stuff like that, that's not lawfare. You know, Elon Musk trying to shut down that center that did the reporting on hate speech is not lawfare, okay? Because it's coming from the right. That's how words work. Anyway, blah, 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 blah. What I love about that is she's an outsider. They're the political elites who will do anything to hold on to power. She's a person who ran for office, was resoundingly defeated, and now cannot conceive of doing anything other than running for office again. You're not an outsider, you're a perpetual candidate in the close Trump orbit who hangs out in Mar-a-Lago. What do you think outsider means? And you sure seem like you'll do anything to gain power, at least in the first place. You know you could get a job, right? She used to be on TV, in a reporter or something. You could do that again. You don't just have to run for office every 2 years for the rest of your life. I don't understand why these people, they get that taste of the notoriety or the clout, and they can never conceive of being an accountant or something. There's a dignity to just working. I'll never understand these people. In any event, Sharon, I do want to turn to you. The defamation lawsuit is going to go forward. We might see a skipping to the damages portion. There could still be discovery where there's some discussion of the claims that she made against him. Maybe some discussion about the harm that he suffered as a result of it. We will have to see. The future of this case is a little bit murky, as well as the timeline. But bear in mind that she is involved in election right now. So what do you think?
I think that I can't wait till they get to the damages portion. I'm guessing, $460 million in damages. I mean, she did a lot of harm to the person who's suing her, and she caused a lot of hurt here. But you mentioned that, you could just get a regular job. She was an anchor, a prominent anchor in Phoenix. I know something about local news anchors and everything you just, they don't really want to work. We don't really necessarily want to work. So this is what she's doing. If you go off the air, some people think that you don't exist anymore. And this is, she's loving every bit of it. The problem is when all the money goes to Trump and his lawyers at the top, there's not gonna be anything left to pay her damages, okay? Nothing at all. But I also think she's taken a page brilliantly out of his playbook with her statement and that glow light. What is that light she
has? It's beautiful. I mean, look, I got
just incredible.
Yeah, look, I'm not gonna act like I don't have lights, Rigby, or whatever. You know, I don't necessarily, I'm not getting washed out to quite the same extent, but I prefer a more authentic, real look. But anyway, look, that is one of the least objectionable things about Kari Lake. The fact that she is a willful tool in the picking apart of American democracy is the bigger issue. And at least for the near future, the election is the big issue. So I'm glad that they're expediting this, because I think we should know what the final resolution of it is going to be. I don't like that she seems to be hoping that this will make less news, that people will have less of an accurate idea of the sort of lies that she slings around. It'll be on the media to make sure that they still report on this. So I leave that to them. For now though, recent polling indicates that with Kyrsten Sinema not going to be involved in this case, this election, Ruben Gallego, the Democratic candidate, is at about 44% of the vote, and Kari Lake is at 40%. So that's good. That's positive. It's not nearly good enough, though, is it? Like, when you really stop and think about this, she has no qualification to be a senator. She ran for office, she told some lies about elections, and she's hung out at a golf course for 2 years. Other than that, why should she be the senator? I don't know. And she's 4 points down under Ruben Gallego, a guy who's actually served in office. But anyway, any concern about that? Any predictions about how it might go before we close things out?
Well, yeah, because it's within the margin of error. So she could actually pull this thing off, and it could hinge on what you said a few moments ago about the media doing their job here. Also, yeah, if she loses, it could be so close, she'll be able to claim the lie again.
Oh yeah, no matter what, if she loses, she's definitely gonna claim the lie. I don't understand why any Republican would admit defeat from now on. There's no incentive to do so. But I will say that if you're lagging behind by 4 points now, and you're probably gonna end up losing this defamation lawsuit, and that'll be a round of negative news, what you could use, Kari Lake, is a candidate who will bring in support for your party, bring over independent voters. But unfortunately, you hitched your wagon to Donald Trump, a guy who has never demonstrated an ability to do that. So that might be the difference between Senator Kari Lake or Kari Lake looking for another thing to run for in 2 years. But stay tuned to find out.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.